Hi everybody, welcome to our online session of the Christian Meditation Prayer Group of St. Mary's Church in Killarney. Thank you for joining us wherever you are, whatever time it might be. I hope you're well and we look forward to a nice meditation together. Despite not being in each other's company, we are spiritually co-located. So we're going to go straight into our meditation practice now. Let us close our eyes and relax our muscles, letting go of the tension that's present in them. And now we remind ourselves that we meditate in the presence of God, God who is always present to everything, all the time, and a fact that we forget very readily. So acknowledging that God is present and that we meditate in order to get closer to God, let us bring that positive energy into our mind and let it flow down into our heart. And then again down into our abdomen. Into our mind. Flow down the spinal column into the heart. And again down into our abdomen. And one more time, let that divine peace settle within our mind, percolate through our nervous system into our heart, and onwards into our abdomen and to the extremities of our nervous system. And by way of final preparation, let us with our mind's eye look towards our heart, towards the immense depth that exists there, because that is where the Spirit of God resides. We do not force the looking, we let it happen naturally, so that it may occur during our meditation according to the will of God. And then at the sound of the gong we bring into our mind our sacred word, Maranatha, and keep coming back to it as often as is necessary. And we don't much mind what happens. Everything okay? A good meditation? I hope so. So we have been journeying up the mountain in the company of Jesus with Peter, James and John throughout our Lent, our Lenten practice. And we have been thinking about the ways in which the concept of Lent, the time of preparation and inward reflection, helps us and encourages us in our meditation practice, and also what it tells us about the manner and the different aspects of meditation, what it is we're doing and why. And we have the last session introduced the idea that the ego is actually the soul the wrong way up, if you will. That is to say, the soul without its proper focus. The soul is our heavenly aspect, and in the soul we engage with the divine creator, we engage with God, the Father, Son and Holy Spirit in the spiritual realm, and that is made manifest to us through our physicality, the humanness of our being. And in terms of that experience, that ability which is given to us, is not a part of our function, as it were, by right. We are given this by grace, that the way in which we understand the spiritual realm makes physical consequences to our lives, to our understanding, to our faith. And that this is where the ego is formed, because the soul loses that sense of its connection with the divine, and then wonders to what does it relate. And when it starts to think like that, the soul becomes the ego. And this idea of the ego being something within us that is constantly needy, constantly needing things, constantly searching, never happy, unless it finds some purpose and function. The only problem for the ego is that for the soul, should I say, is that the ego only has itself to reference. It has nothing outside of itself to connect to, and that's why the ego is very self-centered. But the soul itself, you have to wonder at how it behaves and what its function and purpose is in our physical realm. And this is what Lent is intending or hoping to show us, and our meditation practice helps to reveal to us as we engage with it. And so we, in the process of Lent, we now approach Palm Sunday. On Palm Sunday we celebrate the entry into Jerusalem of Jesus, the Lord. And that entry is a very deliberate statement by Jesus of his divinity and at the same time of his humanity, because he comes riding on a donkey, which is a very profound and important metaphor, an image in the Hebrew mind of the nature of the one who is to come and how that event manifests itself, the prophecy that the one who is to come will enter Jerusalem on a donkey at a certain time. And that's what Jesus chooses to do, in order to make a point, in order to make a statement, and in order to predispose himself to what is to come. So this idea of the soul that we're looking at, the sense in which it needs to be connected with the one who makes things into being, brings them into being. Jesus is the creator, the Son of God, the creator. And it is through Jesus, and indeed the power of the Spirit, the divine wisdom of the Trinity, both working together. One of the ways in which the Hebrews understood the aspects of creation was that they saw that everything was in chaos, and that is to say, nothing was related to anything in the proper way. And this idea of chaos is quite significant in the spiritual sense. And then they saw that the Creator separated things out, divided between one kind and another kind. And that is the role and function of the Creator, is to create entities, to separate out from this amorphous chaos tangible things that are stable and can exist in separation. And then the role of the Divine Wisdom, the third person of the Trinity, is actually to build relationships between them so that they function in the most harmonious way. And we ourselves are caught up in that, and our spirit is that which helps us to have a relationship, not just within the people around us, not just with God, but actually with ourselves also, that we have proper relationship within ourselves. So this idea of the soul then as being the purveyor of connections, the purveyor of relationships, the purveyor of harmony and constancy in relationships, derives from the third person, the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, divine wisdom. And this is the nature of our personhood, the nature of our ability to be fully human in the way that we were made to be. And if we lose this idea of the spirit of our soul as the context of the spirit of the divine wisdom, then we've lost our way. And this is what the journey up the mountain is for, to regain our way, to become people of the way, and as we approach the mountaintop, to bring ourselves into that position, that configuration that will enable the divine wisdom which dwells within us, the Holy Spirit, given to us at our baptism, to become a full part of our consciousness. And then the Holy Spirit that causes something to happen to the soul. And this is a really profound event, because it's not what you would expect. But that theme will be the subject of our following online session, which will be on Good Friday. So I invite you to join us again for a final online session on Good Friday, and in which we will engage with this notion, what it is that the soul does, and why Good Friday is the important point, the important moment for us as we walk up the mountain with Christ and the apostles, to find the insight. We've explored the relationship between the ego and the soul. Now we explore the soul's relationship to God. So I'll see you next week, on next Friday, and Good Friday, at the same time, on an online session, and we will continue towards the end of our journey with Christ this Lenten period. So God bless you all, keep you safe, and join with me next week. Goodbye.